Hello and welcome to all our viewers. I'm the host for today's session and my name is Ravi Kumar. And with me, we have a very special guest, Mr. T.V. Narendran. Mr. T.V. Narendran is the president of Indian Institute of Metals. He's also the CIE president and CEO and managing director of Tata Steel. Thank you so much, sir, for your time and the privilege to speak to you.
My pleasure, Ravi.
Sir, Indian Institute of Metals started as an idea in 1945 and it took shape in 1947. Tell us a bit about the illustrious legacy of Indian Institute of Metals.
So we are celebrating the Platinum Jubilee year this year. I think it's a pretty unique institution because there are many industry associations, there are many associations of academicians, there are many associations of scientists, there are many associations of engineers. But I think this is one association which brings all of them together. And even the way we are structured, the way the leadership rotates between industry and academia and scientists, I think it makes everyone feel very included in the institute, in the way it thinks about the future, the way it brings all these members together and all to work for the good of materials and metals. So I think it's a very unique institution, which is a wonderful bridge between all the stakeholders who are invested in metals and materials. So it has a rich history, it's done some wonderful stuff, it's had some great leadership over the years. And I think there's a lot that we need to keep doing.
So I think in the given time that we are in, I think there is a lot of intent to make India a manufacturing hub. There's a lot of talk about Make in India. So how do you see the role of Indian Institute of Metals going forward, given this, you know, imperatives for a nation like ours?
You know, metals and materials is a very important and integral part of the development of any society. Okay, so if India, as Indians and as India, as we are aspiring to become a 5 trillion economy in the next decade and keep growing, materials and metals will play a very, very important role. And there's a lot of innovation required. There's a lot of knowledge intensity of growth which will manifest itself in the way we grow. So to create that environment, to bring all these stakeholders together, to work on the materials of the future, to work on innovation, to work collaboratively so that the ideas can come out of the collaboration. So Indian Institute of Metals can play a very important role as a platform which brings all these stakeholders together and invest in building the capabilities that are so important for India to become a manufacturing powerhouse and a metals and materials powerhouse. The second thing is India is geologically blessed. Unlike many other countries, India has a lot of resources. Be it iron ore, be it some forms of coal, be it bauxite and many other minerals and materials. So the question is, how do you unlock value? We are very rich below the ground, and how do you translate this richness below the ground into richness above the ground? And I think some of the geologically richest parts of the country are the poorest parts of the country above the ground. So I think there's a lot that we need to do as a country, as industry, as Indian Institute of Metals to make this journey happen in the right way. The second point is we are also wanting to create a future which is greener and cleaner, and where the efficiency of use of materials, efficiency of production of materials, the ecological impact of how we make materials, all has to be rethought. And again here, as technologists, as scientists, as industry, we can all work together to create a much cleaner and greener future and have a cleaner and greener path of development as compared to other countries. And Indian Institute of Metals can play a very, very important role there.
I think you touched upon the point of sustainability and the whole endeavor around making it more fruitful for the nation and different aspects of it. I think all of that has to do with the human talent, the human capital. How do you see the role of IIM to foster a lot of collaboration between academia, technologists, industry bodies, and more importantly, the young talent? How do you want to have them participate in this journey?
You know, we are advantaged because we are demographically a young country, okay? But the challenge is we need to create exciting career options for more than a million youth to join the workforce every month. We are also, it's also important for us to create exciting careers in engineering for engineers, exciting careers in science for scientists, and create the right environment for that. So Indian Institute of Metals, again, as a bridge between academia, industry, and the students, because we have a number of student chapters. I think we have about 27 student chapters. So we can connect with students, get them excited about the businesses that we are in, the work that we are doing, the research that we are doing, and showcase to them what are the possibilities. Because these are all growth areas, and these are all areas where there's a lot of innovation and technology. And we need to get the students more and more involved in the Indian Institute of Metals. We are doing that. We are reaching out to them. They need to feel part of it. They need to be as much a stakeholder as the rest of us. And we have to listen to them, so that we need to hear from them how we can make it more exciting for them. So I think there's a lot that we need to do, rather than assume that students will automatically get attracted to a career in the industries that we are in or in the areas that we do research in. Because there are a lot of competing opportunities as well for the good students. So if we have to win the war for talent, we have to do that extra work to make it an attractive place for talent to come.
I can't agree with you more, Mr. Narendran. I think it's time that we look at the human capital, and I'm sure the interview, the viewers, the youth, are really encouraged by what you said. Going forward, sir, I think digital, as we all know, has been the buzzword. With the advent of analytics, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, there is a role that it can play in the advancement of new materials, looking at the process part of it, the product part of it, and also the technology part of it. How do you see digital playing a role in the future endeavors of IIM?
Well, it will play a very, very important role in multiple ways, right? Firstly, if you are a platform which wants to collaborate, having technology as a backbone helps us collaborate much more than we could have done earlier. Today, we can collaborate across the world. We can collaborate across cities, across institutions. We don't need to be physically in the same place to collaborate. We didn't need to earlier, but now we've got used to collaborating virtually, right? So I think that IIM can play a very big role. Second role which IIM can play using digital technologies is, in this era, you need to be learning all the time. All of us will make a mistake if we assume education ends with schools and colleges. Education continues all through your life. And IIM can provide that platform between the people who have the knowledge and the experience and the people who want to learn. So there's a great opportunity for us to be that bridge between the centers of knowledge and the recipients of knowledge, and IIM can be that intermediary and play a role there. So we can help facilitate this continuous learning. The third part is drive efficiencies, because ultimately it's about resource efficiency. When you look at a sustainable future, it is about designing for reuse and repair. It is about recycling. In all this, again, technology, digital technologies play a big role, because even for a lot of the metals and materials that is produced, it's a process industry. So you generate a huge amount of data as you produce what you produce. And today we are only capturing a fraction of that data and using only a fraction of the data that we capture, right? We are designing new plants, new facilities, because very few countries in the world are building new plants and new assets to produce these materials. So how can we design the learnings of the past into the assets that we are creating for the future? So I think, even if I look at new product development, process improvement, other countries may have taken 10, 20 years to go down a path. We can do it in much less time, because technology is available with us, which is not available to some of them who are ahead of us in the development curve. So I think IIM as an institute can again showcase the possibilities to the multiple stakeholders who are part of it, drive that collaboration, which is so important to accelerate down this path. So the opportunity is immense, and I think there are many amongst our members who are already, whether it's academic institutions or industry, are making great use of digital technologies. We need to, make sure that that is disseminated to everybody else, so that on an average industry and scientific institutions and academia in India operate at a very high level. The other advantage we have as a country is, because the government is investing so much on the digital infrastructure, we have data which is not easily available to other countries who have not invested in the digital infrastructure that India has invested in or is investing in. So again, IIM needs to think about how can we better leverage all these opportunities to deal with the challenges which are there ahead of us.
So you talked about the resource efficiency. I think the world is looking at sustainability as a key enabler of what we do in future. And metal and metallurgists around the world, metallurgists especially around the world, are looking at this metals and mineral space very keenly with what technologies can be embraced so that their environment footprint is checked. How would you see the role of sustainability going forward, especially the growing focus, and because India is also signatory to the Paris Accord, How do you see the role of IIM ensuring that the nation's vision and the opportunity to look at climate change as an important enabler in everything we do? How can IIM play a role in embracing sustainability?
So to me, climate change and sustainability is going to be the predominant challenge and opportunity for the next few decades, right? And as different countries think through the policy framework, the policy roadmap to transition into a greener future, IIM again as a platform which has all the stakeholders who can be involved in solving the problem and creating the solutions can play a role in shaping that policy, right? We can learn from best practices across the world and help the government in India in shaping the right policy, right? The second part is how can we create awareness amongst our members? How can we be a platform for our members so that even the smaller companies who may not be as exposed to the subject as some of the bigger companies are can accelerate down this path. The third is there's a lot of research going on globally on this subject, and I'm sure the academic institutions in India are also doing a lot of research, and how can we showcase that? How can we work with the scientific institutions to translate what is an idea into a lab, into something which is commercially viable? So there is a lot that needs to be done on sustainability, because like I said, it's about resource efficiency. There's a lot of work that needs to be done on carbon capture and storage. There's a lot of work that needs to be done on hydrogen. There are many opportunities that are there to make the materials which will lead to efficient use of vehicles for mobility, for instance, or for windmills or solar panels or whatever, renewable sources of energy. So again, the opportunity is immense to create new materials, to find more innovative ways to drive resource efficiency, both in creation of metals as well as in the use of metals. And so it, to me, is a very important part of the role that IIM can play, and a very important part of the opportunity that IIM can leverage.
Sir, I think you have become the president of IIM in this auspicious year, the institution celebrating 75 years. And I think congratulations to you for that. How, as a president of IIM, what role do you see of IIM in the future discourse, say next 20 to 30 years? What are your focus areas as the president of IIM?
You know, the good thing about these institutions is presidents come and go, but the institution is stronger than the presidents who are there. The presidents come for a one-year tenure. You spend 2 years before that, as a vice president. I think what is more important is all the past presidents are also involved, continuously involved. So the institution has a lot of equity which it builds over a period of time, and a lot of committed people, including the past presidents, who are very involved in shaping the activities of the institute. So I think the institute will outlive me and everybody else, right? What we can do as presidents is plant seeds during our tenure, which will hopefully grow into plants and trees after our tenure, right? And so to me, there are some areas which I think is important to work on. Firstly, to work more closely with the startups. If you really look at what's happening in India, particularly over the last 2-3 years, even this year, India has had 28 unicorns added this year, okay? And India is already the third largest home for unicorns after the US and China, right? And India has about 60 unicorns, of which 28 has been added this year. So the pace at which, students or graduates or postgraduates or anybody, any youth is wanting to become a job creator, wanting to be an entrepreneur, is to me a very exciting opportunity for the country, right? It addresses many things, right, including creating jobs. What is even more exciting as far as I'm concerned is there are so many startups working in material science, right? And how can we as, again, as IIM, be the perfect platform for them? Because we have, as our members, industry, who can be the place where these startups can scale up their ideas. We have academicians, we have scientists. The startups can bounce their ideas to them. So how can we as IIM be the best platform for material science or metallurgy-linked startups, technology-linked startups in the country? That to me is something, and if we can plant the seeds for that, I think it will do the country good, do the startups good, and do IIM good. The second is, I think we need to work on thematic areas, So we talked of climate change. If you pick thematic areas like carbon capture and storage, carbon capture and usage, or hydrogen, or additive materials or medical materials. Pick areas where there is a collaborative, cross-functional kind of team working, because otherwise we've been typically looking at ferrous, non-ferrous, silos like that. Whereas there could be areas for composites, for instance. You could have ferrous, non-ferrous, it could be anybody. And if it's more customer-centric, if it is more usage-centric, if it is cross-disciplinary, if we can pick four or five or six areas which are thematic, which we can work on, create a collaborative environment, then I think again we can do something unique and special. The third is what we discussed slightly earlier, is how can we connect better with the students and the youth and the colleges, and how can we get them into an ecosystem much more, not just to make them listen to us, but how can we listen better to them, and take the ideas that they have. Because if we are talking of the future, the youth have a greater stake in it than some of us have, right? Because if they have to think about what do they want this space to look like in the next 20, 30 years, we should listen to them, The older people may have the knowledge or the experience, but the younger people may have an ambition or an aspiration which we should listen to and help shape the future. So I think IIM can, in my mind, at least in my tenure, what I'm trying to do is, can we have more engagement with the startups? Can we create a better platform for the startups to engage with the IIM? Two is, can we engage better with the students? Can we work on thematic areas? And the fourth, which has already started earlier, which I think we need to continue, is how can we connect better with the international organizations who are like us in the UK or the US or Germany or Japan or Korea or Southeast Asia or wherever else. So we have an international relations committee which is working on it, and I think a lot of collaborations and ideas are being built. So that's another area which we need to build on. So beyond all the great stuff that we do day in and day out and year in and year out. So in addition, I would like to push some of these areas as well.
Absolutely, sir. I think sowing seeds today for tomorrow will be the mantra. And I'm sure under your tenure, the institution will reach newer heights. Institution, the Indian Institute of Metals is celebrating the 75th year of its glorious service to the nation. And on November 13 to 15, they are organizing the annual technical meeting. Any message for the viewers, for the attendees?
I think we need to all work together to make not only IIM a success, but this community a success. And I think we need to create more excitement about the work that all of us do, and make it an exciting, dynamic, innovative place where everyone wants to participate in one way or the other. And the annual technical meets and things like that are great opportunities for us to showcase some fantastic work that is being done. So I look forward to that.
Thank you so much, Mr. Narendra, for your time and perspective. So thank you, viewers. That was Mr. Narendran sharing his valuable insights on the illustrious journey of IIM and what future holds for the Institute and the larger metallurgical fraternity. Wish you all the best. See you next time. Thank you.